Okay, so today we do a slightly more detailed seascape. Paint the sky blue, pretty much like we did the first time. I'm using ultramarine and white with a little bit of water and some flow improver. You go halfway down the page. Not halfway, about three quarters of the way. Mixed plenty of blue and white together in a little pot just to speed up the process. And when that's dried a little, I'll come back and put some clouds in the sky. A bit more colourful. I'm going to have some land part way down, but I just leave a gap and mix a little cerulean blue with my white paint to make a slightly different colour for the sea. I'll take it along to about there, and then that will be the land, but it's easier to do the blue while I've got the colours mixed. Using my filbert brush again. Green there, a bit more there. Now I have some rocks there, so I'll just make a rough line and just trail them down like that and then up very slightly. So all this will be sea. Few white lines to indicate some waves. Still got my husky throat. A bit of distance, I'll just brush that one out a little. Right, wash the brush. A little bit of green, a little bit of ultramarine yellow, and a tiny bit of Payne's grey, so a little bit of white as well, just distant land. And then it's a bit brighter green than I intended, so a bit more Payne's grey and a bit more white. Darken it down a bit because it's in the distance. A little bit of indication of beach. A little bit of land there. So I need little bit more of my blue there. Oops. Push that out a little bit. Slight shadow there as it goes down. White on the edge. Easier if the paper was right in front of me, but then you just see the back of my head, so let's not do that. And then here we're going to have some rocks. So a little bit of yellow, a little bit of grey, bit of brown. And some rocks. Some more grey. As they come into the foreground a little bit more, I'll use my brush to make some shapes, some shadows. I'm going to put some flowers in that corner, so I won't make too much detail of the rocks. A few shadows for rocks, always useful. Because I'm going to put flowers there, I'll just spread that thinly and make some vague rock shapes. Let that dry off while I put more rocks, more detail in the rocks. So, say there's a rock going down like that, maybe. A little bit of shadow between that and the one below it. Just a few lines on that side. And a show at the back of the flowers. Over there and cover that line. So the lighter points on top of the rocks. And then some shadows because they go down. So light on top of that rock. Say the light's coming from the left. A few shadows that side. There. There's a few pieces I've just missed, so I'll go back over those while I wait for the foreground to dry a little. I'm just painting some clouds. I find for clouds, if I dry my brush quite a bit and just dab on some white paint and sort of scrub it around. Especially if I haven't got quite as much paint on that one. Just go around the edge a little bit with that one. Always got a little bit of blue showing through with clouds, or nearly always anyway. Just curve around a little bit. White on that one. To the edge there, to the land. Especially if you've got too much paint on the brush, you can just scrub it about and then you can add a little bit more if you want it. Quite like that cloud. So we've got some clouds in the sky. And we've had some grass in the foreground. Yellow, blue, white, and a little bit of Payne's grey again, and just flick it up like that. Don't want it too realistic, don't want too much detail, just try and keep it loose. It's easy to get too detailed. Slight variation in the colour would be good there. Darks maybe. And that's a bit more distant, so I've added a little bit more white just to fade it out and take it away into the distance. And then I have Rose. Wash the brush well. Peppermint rose and a little bit of white. Just to make the suggestion of a thrift. Pretty pink flower that tends to grow on the sea. But not too much detail, just dab a few bits on. With the point of the filbert brush. Smaller as they get away from you, obviously. And then we have a quick but slightly more detailed seascape. Spend a bit more time on the rocks, making lights on top and shadows underneath. I'll put the completed picture up, but it's nearly there. I'll put it up when I've played around with it just a little bit more. Still a few gaps. Hope I've washed the pink off my brush, yes. A little bit of sea. Waves. And just a little bit more white needed on top of the rocks where the sun's shining. Almost done. Just want a little bit more lights and darks between the rocks. But there we have a little bit more detailed seascape. Hope that's been helpful. I'll do another one later.